Okay, welcome students, welcome to our thermodynamic series in IIT JAM crash course. Okay, now we are going to discuss what is one of the most important aspects in thermodynamics in the initial stages, which is known as PV diagram or indicator diagram. Very important from exam point of view. Okay, in most of the exam there will be definitely one question at least from indicator diagram. It's a gunshot question. Okay, what is this PVR indicator diagram? Okay, PVR indicator diagram is nothing but a graph taking pressure on y-axis and volume on x-axis. Okay, a graph drawn between pressure and volume variations of a gas is known as a PV diagram or indicator diagram. Here, we don't indicate temperature anywhere, only pressure and volume are indicated. Okay, but using that pressure and volume, since PV equal to nRT, we can find out what you call the temperature also. We can estimate the temperature also. Okay, now this is known as an indicator diagram. Okay, volume is usually taken along x-axis. Okay, pressure is usually taken on y-axis. Okay, this graph, PV graph, is known as indicator diagram. Okay, right now initially you take some gas, ideal gas. Okay, it is at some initial temperature T1. Okay, pressure P1, volume V1. Okay, so I'll represent that state of the gas by A. Means initially it is at a point A, say. Okay, what are pressure, volume, temperature, P1, V1? Okay, of course, there is no provision to indicate temperature, so I'm not writing, but it is at temperature T1, say. Now, I'll make some series of changes. Either I'll give some heat energy or take some heat energy. I'll push the piston down or I'll allow the gas to push the piston up. I'll bring some changes in the system such that system goes to a new state where its pressure is P2, volume is V2 and temperature is T2. I'll call this new state of the system as point B. Okay, here that point B is say, okay, P2, V2. Okay, P2, V2. Temperature cannot be indicated, so I'm leaving out temperature. Okay, right now, how the system has gone from A to B, I want to see. Okay, how the system has gone from A to B means, suddenly if I compress the gas, suddenly I'll pull the piston up. Okay, directly I'll go from P1, V1, T1 to P2, V2, T2. Means directly from A, I to B. But I cannot draw a graph. A graph should be drawn means, we should have some points in between. Okay, so if I only two points are indicated in XY graph, okay, nobody can draw any graph here. Okay, A is here, B is here. How to join A and B? How the system has gone from A to B, there is no information. You can take the straight, what you call, path from A to B like this, or you can take a path like this, or you can take the path like this, or you can take a path like this. Okay, all that I have information about system is what? Initially it is at A, finally it is at B, but I don't know, I have no information how the gas has gone from A to B, whether it went like this or like this or like this or like this, no information. Okay, in order to get that information, what should I do? I need some 5 or 10 or 15, the more number of points, okay, I can draw a smoother curve, graph will be smooth. Okay, means how the system has gone from A to B means, okay, I know the pressure volume here. If I know the pressure volume at this point, 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 like this, suppose I take some 10-15 readings in going from A to B, at every point I know what is the volume of the gas, what is the pressure, what is the volume, what is the pressure, what is the volume, what is the pressure. If I have that much information with me, right, I'll get, if the better, the more number of points I get between A and B, the better it will be. Now I'll put all those points. Now I'll join all those points, I'll get a smooth curve. Now I understand how the system has gone from A to B. Okay, means in order to get that information by a smooth curve, okay, I should have as many points as possible in between A and B. Okay, how to get as many points as possible? I cannot suddenly expand the gas or compress the gas from initial state A to final state B. Well, what should I do? I have to allow the gas to expand slightly by a very small volume, then measure its, what you call, pressure as P1 dash, V1 dash. Okay, slowly allow the gas to expand a little bit more. Okay, P1 double dash, P2 double dash, like that means at every point I have to allow the gas to expand slightly and see what is the pressure volume I have to measure. Again, allow the gas to expand slightly, measure what is the pressure, what is volume, like that. Slowly, step by step, we have to keep on increasing the volume, and every time measure what is the pressure, what is the temperature, extra information you have to gather. Okay, such that you will get large number of points in between. We will get a smooth curve in the graph of PV diagram. Okay, indicator diagram we call. Such a slow process, I was mentioning in one of my previous videos, is known as a quasi-static process. Okay, right? So in a PV diagram, only quasi-static processes can be represented, remember. Okay, right? Sudden expansions and sudden compressions. I'll suddenly compress the gas. I know pressure, volume, temperature here. I know final pressure, volume, temperature, but I don't know how pressure and volume are related to each other as the gas is coming down, because I suddenly compressed the gas in 1 second from initial volume to half of its volume. Okay, what happened to the pressure when volume is decreasing? I have no information at all. Okay, in order to have that information, in order to have as many points as possible, okay, such that to get a very smooth curve in the PV diagram, I need to do the process extremely slowly. That means I better more number of points. If I have 50 points in between A and B, means 50 times I have to slowly keep on compressing. Every time I have to measure its temperature, volume, pressure. Every time I have to measure its pressure, volume, temperature, then I'll get a perfectly smooth curve. Okay, I'll understand more about the system or the process. Okay, so right, so PV diagram, right? In a PV diagram, only quasi-static process means process which are done extremely slowly. At every point we should have the information, what is the pressure of the gas at that point, what is the volume, what is the pressure, volume, what is the pressure, volume, like that. Every time I should know. Okay, so one important aspect is what? Only quasi-static process can be represented in a PV diagram. Okay, that is one important one. Next one. Okay, so say you have taken the system from A to B. Okay, you have taken the system from A to B like this. Now I'll draw another graph here. Okay, pressure on y-axis and volume on x-axis. Okay, system has gone from a state A to a state B like this. Okay, how did I get this smooth curve? By measuring the pressure and volume at each point. Means I have done that process, okay, extremely slowly. Which process it is, just guess what is happening. Initially the volume here is V1, okay, or VI. Okay, finally the volume here is VF. Okay, in that process what happened to the volume of the gas? Volume of the gas has increased. Volume of the gas is increasing means what? What type of process it is? It is an expansion. What type of expansion it is? Isothermal or isobaric or adiabatic? We don't know. Okay, we don't know. Some expansion has taken place. What type of process, we have to find out later on. Okay, now, so this is an expansion because volume has increased from VI to a final value. Pressure kept on decreasing like this. Initially here, say the pressure and volume are PI, VI, and here PF, VF. Okay, right, what is the amount of work done in that expansion? Gas is pushing the piston up in expansion. Work is done by the gas. Okay, work is done by the gas. Work done by the gas is positive, I told. Okay, how to find out the work done by the gas in the entire process from A to B? Means general expression for work done, dW equal to pressure into volume. Okay, where dV is an extremely small amount of change in the volume. Okay, so initially suppose say the curve is like this. Okay, at some point P the pressure is constant. I will assume that the volume has changed by an extremely small amount. Okay, dV is an extremely small change in volume. During that small change in volume, I'll assume that pressure is almost constant. So what is the work done in changing the volume by an extremely small amount, dV? It is dW equal to PdV. That is given nothing but area between the area of this strip will give you the work done dW in that extremely small, infinitesimally small expansion dV. Okay, so during that infinitesimally small expansion, we are assuming that pressure remains constant. Okay, so I'll get dW. What is the total? That is nothing but, see, what is nothing but the area of this strip will give you work done in that small expansion. That is dW equal to PdV is nothing but this area of the strip. What is the total work done in going from A to B? What is the total work done in going from A to B? Means, okay, nothing but area of area between the curve and the x-axis or volume axis. Don't remember it as x-axis, better to remember it as volume axis. Okay, sometimes in some exams they'll take volume here and pressure here. Okay, we should not and they'll give some curve like this. What is the work done means we should not calculate the area between the curve and here, that is pressure axis. It is okay, area between the curve and the volume axis, better to remember that way. Let it be given on x-axis or let volume be given on y-axis, doesn't matter. Okay, right now how to get the entire area? Nothing but total work done in that process is integral dw equal to integral pdv. Integral pdv, that is we will get the total area under the curve, right, between the curve and the volume axis. So in an indicator diagram, a process is represented by a smooth curve like this. In order to get a smooth curve, the process should be quasi-static, means should be done extremely slowly. The area between the curve and the volume axis gives the work done in that process. Okay, I told you work is of two types. Work done by the gas is positive, work done on the gas is negative. Okay, now whether work is done by the gas or on the gas, if volume is expanding, if volume is increasing, gas is expanding means volume is increasing, gas is doing the work, the curve will be right going curve like this. Okay, when the curve in the indicator diagram is going towards right, it means that volume is increasing. Volume is increasing means gas is expanding, gas is doing work. So for a right going curve in PV diagram, work is done by the gas. Okay, work is done by the gas. If the curve is like this, okay, it means that volume is increasing from initial volume Vi to a final volume Vf. Okay, when volume is increasing, work is done by the gas. Means for right going curves, the area between the curve and x-axis will give you work done by the gas, or it is taken as positive. Suppose say the curve is like this. The curve is like this. Here, initial volume is this much, final volume is this much. In this process, in going from, right, from this point, what is happening to volume of the gas? Volume of the gas is decreasing. Volume of the gas is decreasing means, what? Somebody is pushing the piston down. Okay, means work is done on the gas. Means for left going curves in the indicator diagram, the work is done on the gas. It is a compression. It is a compression of the gas. Work is done on the gas, or negative work we call. Okay, so, right? So for right going curves, work is done by the gas. For left going curves, work is done on the gas. Okay, in a PV diagram, the situation is like that. Okay, now a cyclic process. Consider some cyclic process. What is a cyclic process? Cyclic process means I'll start from the initial, some initial state of the gas, from P1, V1, T1. I'll go to P2, V2, T2. From there, I'll go to P3, V3, T3. From P3, V3, T3, I'll come back to P1, V1, T1. Okay, means I am starting at some point, I make the gas to undergo a series of changes in its pressure, volume, temperature, thermodynamic coordinates, and I'll bring back the gas to its initial point. Such a process is called a cyclic process. Cyclic process, how do we get the graph? Okay, in a cyclic process, the graph will be like this in a PV diagram. Okay, I'll start from the point A. Okay, I'll go from A to B like this. Okay, it is some expansion only because volume is increasing. What is the work done, right? In that process, it is the area between this curve and x-axis. Area between this curve and x-axis will give you the total amount of work done going from A to B. Because the curve is towards right, I'll say work is done by the gas. It is an expansion process. From B, I'll take it to a point C. Okay, here also, again, volume is increasing. Volume is increasing means it is expansion only. Work is done by the gas only. From C, I'll take the system back to a point D, say. What type of process it is? It can be any process. Okay. Now, here what is happening? Initial volume is this much. Final volume is this much. Means volume is decreasing in going from C to D. Okay. Which type of, what is that? It's nothing but a compression. It can be some compression. Okay. From D, I'll come back to A. Means this is known as a cyclic process. System has undergone a series of changes. It has started from A and came back to A. Okay, right now, what type of curve did I get? I have got a closed loop. Okay, closed curve it is. Means in PV diagram, for a cyclic process, we'll get a closed loop. you'll get a closed loop. Okay, right? Means I have to start from one point, take it to some other changes, and again bring it back. So this is known as, we'll get a closed curve for a cyclic process in an indicator diagram. Okay, now what is happening in going from A to B to C? Work is being done by the gas. In going from C to D to A, work is done on the gas because these are compressions. Okay, which work is more, you tell me? Okay, work done by the gas means from here to here, this area. Okay, work done in going from B to C, area between this curve and volume axis, it is this area. Okay, so what is the total work done in going from A to B to B to C? Okay, this may be a different process, this may be a different process. So you have to find out the work done separately from here to here, from here to here. Okay, this entire area, right, is nothing but work done by the gas. Now what is work done on the gas? On the gas means C to D, right, the curve is like this, area between this curve and volume axis. Okay, this will give me what you call the work done on the gas or by the gas. Okay, here it is on the gas, right, in going from C to D. What is the work done by the gas or on the gas in going from D to A? Area between this curve and volume axis means area between this area will give me the work done on the gas. In going from A to B, B to C, work is done by the gas. In going from C to D, D to A, work is done on the gas. Means gas is doing some work and we are doing some gas on the, some work on the gas. Okay. Gas is doing some work and we are doing some work on the gas. Okay. What is the net work done? Okay. Net work done means, right, that is work done by the gas minus work done on the gas. That is nothing but this is work done on the gas, which is more. Okay, work done by the gas is less. Work done on the gas is suppose say 100 joules. It is given by this area, right? Area between this curve and volume axis. Work done by the gas, area between this curve and the volume axis. This curve area is less. This area is less. Suppose say this is 60 joules. Okay, work done by the gas is 60. Work done on the gas is 100 joules. What is the net amount of work done in this process? Okay, net amount of work done in this process is 100 minus 60, 40 joules is the net amount of work done. Okay, whether it done on the gas or by the gas. Okay, work done on the gas is more, work done by the gas is less, net work is done on the gas only. Okay, that is 60 work done by the gas minus work done on the gas 100, that is equal to minus 40 joules. Minus 40 joules means what? Negative work means work is done on the gas. So what is the net amount of work done means, right, this area minus this area, that is area enclosed by the closed curve, will give you the net work done. Area enclosed by the curve will give you net work done. That is, in the indicator diagram for a cyclic process, I'll get some closed loop like this. I'll go from A to B like this and from B to A like this. What is work done by the gas? This much area between this curve and volume axis. What is work done on the gas? It is area between this curve and volume axis. That is, it is this area. What is the net work done? Right? This area minus this area. Nothing but area enclosed by the closed loop. Area enclosed by the closed loop will give you net work done. Net work done. Okay, whether that network is done by the gas or on the gas. Okay, that also we can find out from the shape of the graph only. Okay, if the graph is like this, okay, we are going from A to B like this, okay, and from B to A like this. Okay, which work is more, tell me? This is by the gas, work done on the gas. Work done on the gas is more because this area is more. Okay, so network is done on the gas only. What type of curve I got? I got a clockwise loop. I got an anti-clockwise loop. For a cyclic process, we'll get a closed loop, a closed curve. Okay, if the closed loop is anti-clockwise, network is done on the gas. Now, in another example, suppose I go from A to B, okay, like this, and come from B to A like this. Work done. Okay, work done by the gas means area between this curve and volume axis. This is more. Work done on the gas means area between this curve and volume axis. This is less. So, net work is done by the gas only. Okay, network is given by the area of the closed loop. So area of the closed loop in PV diagram gives network done in that cyclic process. If the curve, what type of curve did we get? It is a clockwise loop. Okay, if the loop is clockwise, work network is done by the gas. The loop is anti-clockwise, network is done on the gas. Remember like that. So problems will be coming. They'll give you what you call some different shapes. What is the network done in the process, or what is the work done in so and so process, like that. They'll give different types of questions. The questions will be like this. Okay, now in a PV diagram, here volume, here pressure. Okay, they'll give some curve like this. System has gone from A to B to C like this. What is the network done in the process? Network done by the gas or on the gas? Simply look at the curve. This is a closed loop. Okay, this is a closed loop. So network is done, given by the area of this. What is the geometrical shape? Triangle. Triangle's area, you know, half base into height. Okay, whether work is done on the gas or by the gas. Look whether the loop is clockwise or anti-clockwise. The loop is clockwise. Okay, therefore, network is done by the gas only. Okay, if the loop is given in opposite direction like this, it is an anti-clockwise loop. Network is done on the gas, we say. Okay, they may give any shape. Okay, they may give a process like this from A, B, right, C, D, A. A, B, C, D, A is a cyclical process. What is the network done in the process, or what is the work done in going from B to C or C to A? Such problems we can see. Looking at how the graph is going, right, in PV diagram or indicator diagram, this is extremely important from all exams point of view. Okay, right, I'll show you some figures, right, and see how to calculate work done in the entire process, if it's a cyclic process, or in any given process, what is the amount of work done also, we'll see. So consider a PV diagram like this. Okay, now it will give you some path, a closed path like this. Okay, right, a cyclic process represented by A, B, C, A. System is going from A to B, right, in this way. System is coming down, coming from B to C like this, and again going back to its initial stage A. It's a cyclic process. Okay, right, in a cyclic process, what have we seen, right? Area enclosed by the closed path. Area enclosed by the closed path gives you network done in the process. Means area of this triangle is nothing but the network done in the cyclic process A, B, C, A. Now, what is area of this triangle? Half into base into height. Say, for example, here the volume is given as V, here the volume is given as 2V. Okay, here the volume is given as, sorry, pressure is given as P. Here the pressure is given as 2P, say. Okay, what base, half base into height of the triangle? That is, what is base here? 2V minus V is nothing but V into 2P minus P is nothing but P. That is, see, what is the work done? Half PV, right? Okay, he may give you any geometrical figure like an ellipse or something like a rectangle or a square, whatever it is. Area enclosed by the closed path will give us network done in that process. Is the network done by the gas or on the gas? If the loop is clockwise, network is done by the gas. If the loop is anti-clockwise, network is done on the gas. So here this one is a clockwise loop, so network, this much work is done by the gas. Okay, right, now we can analyze further also. What type of a process is AB? What type of a process is CA? What type of process is BC? We can evaluate. Now here in this diagram, see, from A to B, what is happening? Volume is not changing. Volume is remaining as V only. System's pressure is increasing from A to B. Means what type of process is AB? AB is an isochoric process. Okay, isochoric, constant volume process. Because, right, volume is not changing. Volume is remaining as V only in going from A to B. Okay, B to C, we don't know what type of process it is. Volume is increasing, no doubt, pressure is decreasing, but we don't know. Okay, but C to A, you see. Okay, C to A, what type of process it is? Okay, volume is coming down from 2V to V, but pressure is remaining as P only. Throughout the path CA, pressure is not changing, pressure is remaining as P only. Okay, right, so what type of process it is? It is, CA is an isobaric process. CA is an isobaric process, we call it. Okay, we don't know what you call, what type of process BC, unless and until mentioned. Okay, right, so by looking at the graph also, we can tell which process is what type of process to the maximum extent, we can conclude. Okay, now suppose, say,
And another diagram is given like this. Okay, the process, cyclic process is happening in such a way so that it starts from A, goes to B, and right like this, and comes back from B to A like this. Okay, right here the volume is V, here it is 2V, here the volume is 3V given, say here the pressure is P, here the at this point pressure is 2P. Say what is the network done in this process? What is the network done in the process means area enclosed by the right closed loop gives you network done, means area of this ellipse becomes the network done. Is network done by the gas or on the gas? Here the loop is anti-clockwise, so network is done on the gas, we say. Now what is area of an ellipse? Area of an ellipse is pi into AB, right? Okay, A is semi-major axis, B is semi-minor axis. Okay, means from the center, right, up to this point, from the center up to this point, pi into A into B. So here what is what done? W equal to pi into what is A semi-major axis from 2V, volume is changing to 3V. Okay, that is 3V minus 2V, right? A is nothing but V. Similarly, B, pressure is here P, and here it is suppose 3P for simplicity purposes. Okay, so here somewhere it will be 2P, right? From 2P to it is changing to 3P, that is change in pressure from here to here is how much? P. So pi PV, right? So what is the answer? Okay, work done will be pi PV. Okay, next time he may give you a circle also. Okay, if he gives a circle like this, okay, clockwise or anti-clockwise circle, right? Here you should not take area of a what you call circle is pi r square, sir. So I take only this volume. Okay, here volume is V, here volume is 2V. Okay, here pressure is P, here pressure is 2P, say. Okay, so what is the network done? Area enclosed by the circle. Area enclosed by the circle is pi r square. So you cannot write as pi into radius, means you can take this as radius or this as radius. It makes no difference. Okay. Right, so you should not say so 2V minus here it is somewhere 1.5V, so it is half V only, half V whole square. No, area is pressure into volume. Pressure into volume means you have to take this parameter and this dimension also. Okay, so here pressure is changing from right 1.5 to 2P, that is 0.5P, that is half P. Okay, here volume is changing from 1.5 to 2V, right, it is half V. Therefore, it is nothing but pi PV by 4 is the amount of work done. Even though it is a circle, you have to take A into B only. Okay, for a circle, A is numerically equal to B. Okay, pressure dimension and volume dimension both should be considered here. Okay, like this, different diagrams will be given. But sometimes the question may come, questions may come like this also. Okay, some process they will give. Okay, in a PV diagram, right, they'll take V on y axis, pressure on x axis, and they'll give you some process like this. Okay, system is going from A to B. What is the amount of work done? Okay, they'll give some parameters here. Volume is suppose say V1. Okay, volume is suppose say V2 here. Okay, pressure here is P1, pressure here is P2. Now, what is the amount of work done? Area between the curve and x axis. Area between the curve and volume axis, I told you. Okay, means it is not this area under the curve as usual. Till now we are taking this area because here pressure was there, here volume was there, pressure was here. Okay, but now volume is given here, pressure is given here. Area between the curve and the volume axis gives us network done, means it is this area under consideration. Okay, we have to consider this area. We should be careful, right? Where is that volume axis given? Sometimes volume they take here, sometimes they take volume here. When they take volume here, it is area between the curve and the volume axis which is important to us. Means it is this area which gives the network done, sorry, the work done in this process going from A to B. Okay, if volume is increasing, it is expansion, work is done by the gas. If volume is decreasing, it is compression of the gas. Okay, work is done on the gas, negative work we get. Okay, right, so be careful in solving problems. Okay, where is volume given? Okay, now in a PV diagram in general we can write like this. Okay, for a polytropic process, see, we have got for an ideal gas, PV equal to RT for 1 mole. Okay, in an isothermal process, T also remains constant. So PV equal to some constant K, we can write. Okay, K is a constant. Right, this is for an isothermal process. Whereas for an adiabatic process, okay, we got PV to the power gamma equal to some constant K. Okay, PV to the power gamma equal to constant K. Apart from these two, in general, for a polytropic process, okay, we can write this as PV to the power N equal to constant. PV to the power N equal to constant K. Okay, right? Where N is known as polytropic exponential. Okay, other than, right, for if you compare these two, for an isothermal process, N is equal to 1. For an adiabatic process, N equal to gamma. Other than N equal to 1 and gamma, remaining process can happen anyway. It is known as a polytropic process. Okay, so we can write in general PV to the power N equal to constant. Okay, in an indicator diagram, if I try to draw like this, P and V. Okay, right? Say N equal to 0. N equal to 0 means, okay, V to the power 0 is 1. So P equal to constant we get. P equal to constant means what type of process it is? Isobaric process. Isobaric process, pressure should remain constant. Okay, volume can change. In expansion, volume keeps on increasing. In compression, volume keeps on decreasing. So when N equal to 0, right, in a polytropic process, I am getting, that is an isobaric process, I am getting a line horizontal line or line parallel to x-axis or volume axis I am getting. Okay, this is an isobaric process. Okay. If I put N equal to 1, it is nothing but PV equal to constant. PV equal to constant is nothing but for an isothermal process. That is, P is proportional to 1 by V. Okay, or PV equal to constant. Okay, so, right, P proportional to 1 by V graph will be like this. It is a rectangular hyperbola for which N is equal to 1. Okay, this process is an isothermal process. Okay. Right now, in an adiabatic process, what will happen? N equal to gamma, if I put PV to the power gamma equal to constant, gamma is always greater than 1. For N only, I got N equal to 1, I got a curve like this. N is now greater than 1, so the curve will be steeper like this. I take N equal to gamma. This represents an adiabatic process. So, the shape of the curves for isobaric, isothermal and adiabatic, right, process in a PV diagram will be like this. Now, what is the significance of this N? Okay, from N, how should we understand all these things means? It is like this. Okay. Now, what is slope of a curve in PV diagram? In general, dp by dv, dy by dx is slope. Okay, dp by dv will give you, dp by dv will give you slope of the curve. Okay, so for a polytropic process, PV to the power N equal to some constant, say. Now we have to differentiate, we want to find out what is slope of the curve in PV diagram. I told you, I expect some differentiation knowledge. Okay, it's nothing but UV rule differentiation. Okay, right, P, N, V to the power N minus 1 into dV. Differentiation, okay, plus V to the power N into dP equal to differentiation of a constant will give you 0. So if you differentiate this equation, P V to the power N equal to K, right, P into, right, UV rule, it is, right, dV is nothing but N V to the power N minus 1 into dV plus V to the power N into dP is equal to 0. Okay, so simplify this, take this to the other side. Take one parameter to the other side. Okay, NP V to the power N minus 1 into dV is equal to minus of V to the power N into dP. Bring that V to the power N to this side. Okay, right, what will happen? V to the power N minus 1 by V to the power N. This N goes up and becomes minus N. N minus N will be 0, right? It will be nothing but V to the power minus 1 remains. Okay, so NP V to the power minus 1 dV is equal to right? Minus V to the power n is gone now. Okay, so it is simply dp. So I want slope dp by dv. Slope dp by dv is nothing but dp by dv. Okay, dp by dv is nothing but np by v with minus sign. Okay, with minus sign. So slope is dp by dv is equal to minus n into p by v. If n is positive, n is polytropic exponential. If n is positive, slope will be negative. Okay, if n is negative, slope will be positive. Okay, minus half minus will become positive. So in the earlier graphs, if you carefully observe, okay, here the curves are having negative slope. That's why n is positive. N equal to 1, n equal to gamma, we are writing. Okay, slope of a line. How do we find out slope? In general, dy by dx. Okay, if a graph is like this, y, x. A curve is like this. What is its slope? Okay, generally, dy by dx is a slope. Because here, right, x is changing. X is changing from this point to this point. But is y changing? Y remains constant. So change in y for change in x is 0. So slope of this line equal to 0. Slope of line parallel to x-axis is 0, right? Okay, similarly, suppose a slope curve is like this. Okay, its slope is, what is happening here, when x is increasing from this point to this point, x keeps on increasing but y value is decreasing. When dx is positive, dy is negative. Okay, when dx is increasing, dy is decreasing. Or you come from here to here, when x is decreasing, y value is increasing. So dy by dx for this curve, okay, is negative, right? Slope of this curve will be negative. Okay, right, if the curve is like this, what is happening, right? X, when x value is increasing, y value is also increasing, means dx is also positive, dy is also positive. That is change. As x increases, y is also increasing. From here to here, y value is also increasing as x increases. So dy by dx for a curve is positive, right? Okay, if the curve is like this, what is happening? Okay, what is happening if the curve is this way, right? Here x is not changing, x is remaining same. Okay, right, x is remaining same. Okay, x is remaining same, y value is changing, means dx is 0, dy is having something, something by 0 is infinity. So slope for these lines will be, if a line comes like this, okay, slope is 0. If a line comes like this, slope is infinity. If a line is like this, slope is negative. If a line is like this, slope is positive. If a line is like this, slope is negative. This is negative slope. This is positive slope. This is slope 0. Okay, slope is infinity for this curve. Now compare this with the curves what we have got. Okay, compare this with what we have got earlier. Okay, what is the slope of this curve at this point? I'll draw a tangent to this one. Okay, slope is like this, the curve is like this, slope is negative. Okay, negative slope means n should be positive, polytropic exponential is positive, I told. Okay, for this curve, slope means at this point, what is the slope? I'll draw a tangent to this one. This curve also, slope is negative. Okay, means for this curve, slope is negative, n will be positive. N will be positive. So, this is for n equal to 0, isobaric process. This is for n equal to 1. Okay, I can take this as the opposite of slope, actually, with opposite slope with opposite sign. Okay, n equal to 1, n equal to gamma. Therefore, in a PV diagram, slope of an adiabatic is gamma times more than the slope of the isothermal. Okay, here we have gamma, here we have n. For n, we got the curve like this. For n equal to gamma, the curve is steeper. This is a rectangular hyperbola. This is a much steeper graph. Okay, gamma times. So slope of the adiabatic is gamma times more than slope of the isothermal in a PV diagram. Okay. Now, what about the polytropic exponential for an isochoric process? Isochoric process means volume should remain constant. Okay, pressure may increase or decrease, means we get the graph like this. If the curve is like this, which is parallel to y-axis at constant V. Okay, this is an isochoric process. Isochoric process. Isochoric process. Okay, curve will be like this. What is the slope? Slope is equal to infinity. That is, n will be equal to infinity. Okay, because slope means dp by dv. Okay, here in this process, volume is not changing. Volume is not changing. So dv equal to 0. So something by 0 is infinity. Slope is equal to infinity. Okay, so an isobaric process is represented like this. Adiabatic process is a steeper curve than isothermal process. Okay, for an isobaric process, we get a horizontal line parallel to volume axis. Okay, these are different types of curves. So what can we understand? One thing is, for an isothermal process, it will be like this. For an adiabatic process, the curve is steeper. Okay, of course, right? I cannot tell by simply looking at a curve like this. Okay, looking at a curve like this, I cannot tell whether it is adiabatic or isothermal. Unless and until specifically mentioned, we cannot tell. But whatever, if this is an isothermal, if this is an isothermal, adiabatic curve will be steeper than this. That much we can tell. Okay, if this is an adiabatic curve, isothermal will be somewhat lesser steep. I will have, what you call, lesser slope. Okay, it will be like this. This will be an isothermal, this will be an adiabatic. If this is an isothermal, this will be an adiabatic like that. Okay, right? Now, say, I told you in PV diagram, temperature is not indicated, but we can compare two curves and tell which is having more temperature, which is having less temperature, we can tell. Okay, so take one PV diagram like this. You take two isothermal process. AB is one isothermal process. CD is another isothermal process. CD is another isothermal process. Okay, this is occurring at a constant temperature T1. This is occurring at a constant temperature T2. Okay, T1 greater than T2 or T1 equal to T2 or T1 less than T2 or we cannot tell anything about like that. Some questions will keep on coming. Okay, by looking at these two curves, we can tell which temperature is higher. Both are isothermal only. This is occurring at a constant temperature T1. This is occurring at a constant temperature T2. Now, okay. Now, how can I tell, right? What is the work done? Work done in isothermal process in general, W equal to nRT, right? Log V2 by V1 to the base E. That's what we have seen. Okay, both are starting from the same volume, both are ending at the same volume, say. Both are starting from the same point and ending at the same volume. So, V2 and V1 are same in both the process. In whichever process work done is more, temperature will be more. In whichever process work done is less, temperature will be less. Okay, now what is the work done in an indicator diagram? Area between the curve and the volume axis will give you work done. So, what is the work done in this process? It is area between this curve and this one. Means this one, this much area is the work done here. What is a work done in this process CD? It is this entire area. This area is greater than this area now. Means work done in process CD is more than the work done in process AB. Okay, V2 and V1 are same. What you call N is same for same amount of gas. R is a constant. Obviously, temperature in CD should be greater than temperature in AB process. So, if different curves are given like this, in a PV diagram, 1, 2, 3, all are starting from the same volume. Okay, and ending at the same volume like this. This is T1, this is T2, this is T3. We can easily tell that T3 is greater than T2 is greater than T1. Means this isothermal is occurring at a higher temperature than this isothermal process. Okay, this is how many problems will come. This is an important one from exam point of view. Okay, definitely in many exams, you can expect at least one question from this topic of specific heats and indicator diagrams. Okay.